by his name, that now he stands among the peoples. Sing to him, sing praises to him, tell of all his wondrous works, glory in his holy name. Let Christ arise to seek the Lord with us. Seek the Lord in his strength. Seek his presence continually. Remember the wondrous works he has done, his miracles, and the judgments he has done. For the offspring of Abraham, his servant, children of Israel, his chosen ones. He is a work of God, his judgments, and all this. He remembers his covenant, the word that he commanded for a thousand generations, the covenant that he made with Abraham, his sworn promise. Which is important to give up the scripture to Israel as an everlasting covenant, saying, to you I will give the land of Canaan as your portion for an inheritance. When they were fully mounted, the little account of his organism, wandering from nation to nation, from one kingdom to another kingdom, he allowed no one to oppose them. He rebuked kings on their behalf, saying, not my anointed ones, do my prophets no harm. When the sun was coming on the land and the all supplies of bread, he had sent a man before him, Joseph, who was sold as a slave. His feet were filled with fetters, his neck was totally covered by him, until what he had said came to pass, the word of the Lord tested him. It loosened and released him. The ruler of the peoples set him free. He made him lord of his castle and ruler of all his possessions to bind his princes to his covenant and to teach his people's wisdom. Then Israel came to Egypt. Jacob sojourned to the land of Ham, and the Lord made his people pale and fearful, and made them stronger than their fathers. He turned their hearts to hate his people, to build Strathfield with his servants. He sent Moses, his servant, and Aaron, and their chosen. They performed his signs among them, and miracles in the land of Canaan. They sent darkness and made the land dark. They did not rebel against his words. He turned their waters into blood and caused their fish to die. Their land swarmed with flocks, even in the chambers of their kings. He spoke, and there came swarms of flies and rats throughout the country. He gave them fire for rain and fiery lightning bolts through their land. He struck down their vines and fruit trees and shattered the trees of their country. He spoke, and the locusts came, young locusts without number, which devoured all the vegetation in the land and ate up the fruit that they grew. He struck down all the firstborn in this land. They stayed short of all their strength. Then he blessed Israel with silver and gold, and there was none among his tribes to stand up. Egypt was growing for Jared, for Jordan, for one point. He spread a cloud for the covering and fire to be light by night. Then he asked, and he brought fire, and gave them blood from heaven in abundance. He opened the rock, and water gushed out its sources in the desert like a river. So he remembered his holy promise, and Abraham, his servant. So he brought his people out with joy, his chosen ones with singing, and he gave them the land of the nations, and they took possession of the fruit of the people's fruit, that they might keep his statutes and observe his laws.
I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you.
verse 11 speaks about some typical promises, one of which, as you saw, is the giving of land to this people. It's not just the fact that God needs to come before us, but it's the reason for greatness. Rather, it's just the fact that God is faithful and committed and trustworthy in taking his promises. That is the real reason for greatness. But it's not just the reason for promises that is the good thing. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. These words. it is often true. Because often the actual offsprings refer to many, but refer to one. Because your offspring is Christ's. In other words, the promise of God to Abraham was that one day he would give a nation of people to a promised land. Thank you.